This week, Netflix announced 5 new releases, involving a possessed Bratz doll, Borat's new lockdown trim, and Adam Sandler reacting badly to the 10 p.m. curfew.
Help me!
I'm Barty Crease, and this is Netflix News. At number 1, it's The Haunting of Bly Manor, an eerie gothic romance in which children spend less time on TikTok and more time birdwatching. Set in 1980s England, the series sees an American nanny taking care of 2 British orphans, before realising she's staying at the world's worst Airbnb. Alarm bells start ringing when the au pair spots a demon doggy paddling in the local pond, and it's not long before she begins uncovering dark secrets and confusing messages from Banksy. The series drops today as the second instalment after The Haunting of Hill House. It should buy the producers just enough time to lock in Lenny Henry for Series 3, The Haunting of Premier Inn. Also dropping today is The 40-Year-Old Virgin, winner of the Sundance Directing Prize and also the Oscar for the peachiest on-screen bottom. Produced alongside Lena Waithe, the film follows Rada, a washed-up New York playwright who spends her days doing Sudoku and singing at people on their lunch breaks. Desperate to make her big break before 40, she reinvents herself as a rapper named Rademus Prime and uses her music to ask all of life's big questions.
Why my skin so dry? Why am I yawning right now?
Torn between her love of theatre and her passion for rap, the film is a story of conflict, indecision and uncertainty, making it quite literally a game of would you rather. Next up is Hubie Halloween, a film in which Adam Sandler discovers the joys of Boris bikes and tries to impress the ladies with his 4-inch flask. He plays the role of Hubie, a local loser who regularly finds himself being pranked and pelted by fellow townsfolk, who clearly have no appreciation for Freddie Mercury cosplay. However, when a deranged sheep begins abducting locals, Hubie suits up and soars into action with all the grace of a Ryanair flight. Aside from Sandler, the film features a range of other talent, including Steve Buscemi, Maya Rudolph, and Demogorgon magnate Noah Schnapp. Netflix News also reached out to fellow co-star Keenan, although things quickly turned sour when we asked, who loves orange soda?
Salem PD.
Who loves orange soda?
Hubie Halloween is out now. On the 16th of October, Borat and Eddie Redmayne team up to take on the police in the trial of the Chicago 7. Directed by Academy Award winner Aaron Sorkin, the film sees a group of people dressed for Glastonbury protesting the Vietnam War. 7 individuals are then singled out and charged with a conspiracy to incite a riot, at which point Eddie Redmayne desperately attempts to summon a hippogriff. The rest of the film entails the 7 going against an angry judge who spends most of the time banging his hammer, like a smaller, bolder Thor. Many have already predicted Oscar nominations for the film's ensemble cast, although the real hero is this lady, who managed to create a convincing protest sign using only Microsoft Paint. And finally, as part of a selection of black British stories, Netflix has released the classic British sitcom Desmond's, a Peck and Barber shop that doubles up as a social hub in South London. Across each half-hour episode, viewers can expect dancing, dominoes and dirty trims, as well as an exclusive look at the new MacBook Pro. Desmond's was one of Channel 4's longest running sitcoms, but the barbershop was forced to close after customers started going to Turkey for a hairline instead. Series 1 to 6 are available to watch now. Until next time, I'm Barty Crease, and this is Netflix News.